Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can set up page layout in Salesforce Classic. Before starting, let me share you how you can follow Salesforce related video series. You can search me on YouTube by my name so that you can follow my videos. So here, first let me open account record. So you will see this is the page where some fields are available that are displaying information related to this record. And later on, these are some related lists which are related with this account object. Right? Now I am opening employee object in another tab and opening this record. So here you will see only employee details are available and also in single column. No field is available in at right hand side in second column, and you can see no related list is available. So now you need to know how we can edit the page layout for this employee object or any other object in Salesforce Classic. So I am opening setup in new window, sorry, new tab. So we have this employee object page here. So here you will see the option for page layout here. So you can click on edit to modify the page layout for this employee object. And also you can notice that here one option is available, that is for edit layout. So this will directly take you to the edit layout of this employee object. So now from here, I'm going to click on edit. So this is the edit view of this page layout. So at left hand side, you can see certain options are available like fields or buttons, quick action, mobile and lightning action, expanded lookups, related lists, report charts. And at right hand side, this field, related fields are available. So if you select on fields, so available fields will be displayed here. If you click on button, so button will be available. If you click on quick action will be available. If you click on related list, so related list options are available here. So first, I'm going to modify the field design or layout. So employee name, I'm shifting employee ID at right hand side. So you just need to simply drag and drop fields. Like I want to shift designation two fields above. So I'm clicking and dragging and dropping this field. Then I have career objective, so I'm putting it here. Then I have account. Then I have opportunity. Then I have salary. Then I have family background. And then city and country. So this way I manage all the fields in two columns, right? Now here you can see different sections are also available like information, system information, custom links. So now if you want to create your own section, so at top you can see there are two options, section and blank space. So I'm clicking and dragging and dropping section here. So it is asking for the name. So I'm typing address information. It is asking whether you want single column layout or multi-column layout. Then navigation order, like from left to right or top to down for tab. So I'm selecting two column and left to right tab key order. And display this section header on detail page as well as on edit page. So I'm clicking on OK. So this is the detail page. And if we click on the edit, so it will show the edit page, right? So here you can notice this information is available on edit page, but this is not available on the detail page, right? So this address information section is available here. I am dragging and dropping city and country here. So this way now page layout, or you can say detail page or edit page, will be having two sections, right? Now, if you want to modify the settings, so you can click on this property icon And if you want to show this information on detail page also, so you can click here and click on OK, right? So this way you can modify the settings. Now, if you want to remove the custom section that are created by you, so you can simply click on this icon. So it will remove the section. And if you want to modify the field settings, so you can have this property option, click on this. So here you will have two options, read only or required. So if you want to make this field as read only, you can select this checkbox. If you want to mark this field as required, so you can click on this checkbox. So if it is required, then you cannot keep it as read only. So I'm leaving it as it is. Then at bottom, you can see there is no related list. So let me first save it so that we can view the changes. Then we will look for the related list, how we can add those. So here you can see the whole layout has changed. It is showing two sections, information and address information. If you click on this, so it will automatically hide the fields which are available on information. So these are the accordions. So you can use these to hide the information. Now, if you click on edit, so edit will also show you two different sections. So I hope you understood how we can modify the page layout. Now I'm going to add the related list. So this time I'm going to click on this. So it will also open the edit layout page. Now I'm going to click on related list. So these are the related lists which are available that you can use. So I'm putting approval history, files, notes and attachments. So I'm putting these three related lists. If you want to see the settings, you can click here. And if you want to add the fields that you want to display on related list, so you can add them from the available fields. Right now, these are the selected fields. So you can see here, these fields are available. For files, there are no fields and you cannot modify the setting. Same for notes and attachment, right? So now you can also click on quick save. So it will save the changes made by you, but it will not close this edit page layout. So you just simply need to open another tab, go for employee record, scroll down, and you can see the related lists are available here. So if you want to attach any file, you can click here and you can attach the files. So this way you can simply add related lists. You can modify the location of the fields. You can have different sections for your page layout. So I hope you understood how we can manage these things. Then you also have one option, buttons. Like these buttons are available here. So if you want to remove or add buttons, you can click on buttons and then you can add or remove these buttons. And these quick action and mobile and lightning actions, these are for lightning experience. So when you will be watching my lightning related videos, so you will learn how we can use these things. So I hope you have understood how we can modify page layouts in Salesforce Classic, both for detail page or edit page, and how we can add the related list on the detail page so that we can link our object with other objects. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to follow Salesforce related videos, you can search me on YouTube by my name. Thank you for watching this video.